Hi, my name's John. Welcome to Hascasts, helping you into the world of home automation one step at a time. What we're going to do is, in this episode, we're going to carry on with our series and we're going to configure has.io. Let's get to it. Okay, so if you remember last time, we just finished installing has.io and I left you on the configuration screen. However, what we're going to do first is we're going to go to our virtual machine and we're going to take a snapshot and we're going to call it post has.io install. I've just realized I think that's what I called the last one when it was actually pre has.io install. However, the time stamped, so it doesn't really matter. Okay. Now, remember that you can always do it from here. Yeah, I did. Right, so what we're going to do is we are going to if you are still in the virtual machine, just type shutdown now. You may have to type sudo space at the beginning if it doesn't let you. Right, that will shut down our virtual machine. It does mean that, as you can see here, connection lost, reconnecting. It will reconnect in a moment. What we're going to do is we're going to make sure in VirtualBox our virtual machine is selected. The arrow at the side of start, if we look down, there's one called headless start. We're going to click on that. What that is going to do is that is going to start the virtual machine in the background. So it's running, but we can't see it. That's all we need to do for that. And then we can now actually exit VirtualBox and it will still run. Awesome. Right, so pretty shortly, in a minute or so, the has.io screen will reconnect. Awesome. Right, so it's now reconnected. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to go into has.io and yet another backup. If we go into snapshots, we can see that we can now take a backup of our system. And on the has.io side, this just means, well, it's not even just, it's fantastic. This means that we can take a snapshot of our has.io system, and if anything goes wrong with any of the configs, then we can just come back and recreate them. Or we can start again with a fresh install of has.io on this side without touching VirtualBox. Alright, so if we just put initial installation. Right, make sure it's a full installation and create it. And that is instantly created, which is awesome. Right, if we now go to configuration, I'll quickly show you around the configuration screens. Right, so the Home Assistant Cloud. If you happen to have Amazon Alexa, then the developers at Home Assistant have created this this component that easily allows you to control your devices from Home Assistant without much work at all. It is really quite good. We'll go into that one later. Right, inside the General tab, you can check your configuration files for errors. If you run into problems at all, this is one of the first places where you should stop. It does kick up a lot of things. Okay, so when you carry out certain functions, such as adding components or updating things, sometimes the server needs restarting. Sometimes, however, you can get away with just restarting certain parts of Home Assistant. You can choose your language, that's pretty obvious. Okay, customizations. Here you can customize so any of your entities, they're known as, any of your items, you can customize in certain ways, icons, names, they're all in the customization screen. Automations. Okay, so here you can, when the sun goes down, you can offset it. So you can put in your triggers, what is going to trigger your automation. Are there any conditions? I only want it to run on Wednesday between 8 a.m. and 8:15 a.m. And what do you want it to do? So, yeah, I don't want to save it. Next is scripts. Scripts, if you think of scripts as a list of actions. So, Home Assistant, I want you to do this. Then I want you to do this. Then I want you to do this. Then I want you to do this. And that way, say for instance, you have a remote control programmed in. You can say, I want you to press button 1. 0, 1, enter, red button, down, select this, flick the kettle on, turn the lights down, all sorts of things. Okay, right, now the important bit. We are now going to go into has.io and we are going to install an add-on. In has.io, one of the fantastic features of has.io is the add-on store. Some of the things in here, before the add-on store and in the normal version of Home Assistant, they actually take, they don't take too much work, but they take a bit of work to do. They involve going into the code editor, into the terminal, command line, whatever you want to call it, and playing around in there. However, with the advent of has.io and the add-on store, some of these things are so simple, it is near enough unbelievable. This one is called Configurator. So find Configurator, install it, and what this will allow us to do is this will allow us to edit our Home Assistant configuration files from within our browser, from within the Home Assistant window itself. Right, so we want it to start, we want it to auto-update. And now I looked at this on GitHub earlier, and I thought it had been fixed. I will have to submit a fix for it. Right, okay. If you look at the config in this box here, the good thing is that even the configuration for the configuration file editor is done in the browser. You don't need to touch the terminal. But if we try to save it as it is, we'll see that we get an error. According to the documentation for this add-on, the only required parameter is password. If we have a look at password here, we'll see that the value for that parameter is null. That basically means it's not there. So what we're going to do is we're just going to select quote admin quote for the username, copy that, and we'll paste it there. So now both the username and password are called admin. Then we'll save. The error goes away. You can see the default port 3218. And then we're going to start it. right. Once it's started, it will give you an option to open the web interface. See, it's green, so it's running. And if we remember, for me, username and password are both admin. Right. So, what we're going to do now, we're going to make it so that we can, so that we have a link to our configuration files in our left-hand side, because currently that is not the default. So this this folder in the top left-hand corner, that is our file system. If we click on that, the main configuration file for Home Assistant is configuration.yaml. If we click on that, it will load up. Click outside of that left-hand column, and here it is. Now, this is our main configuration file. There are others, but one nuance, if you like, of YAML files is white space. For each level of indentation, it has to be indented by two spaces. So here, for instance, you can see the HTTP directive has got some children underneath it, a level of hierarchy. They're commented out at the moment, but you can see that, you can see here, one, two spaces, and then the line begins. Anything, if you're not used to it, anything that begins with a hash or a pound for you Yanks, is a comment, and it isn't taken into account. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to scroll to the bottom. Right, and we are going to paste in, let me see if I can find it on my panel, iframe, awesome. And we are going to paste in just a bunch of text, and that is going to tell Home Assistant that in the left hand side we want to display an option with the title of Configurator. Its icon is going to be a wrench or a spanner, and we're going to change the address here to make sure it reads this address up here. So if we select all, copy the address, and I believe it will inject the HTTP protocol by default. So select that. Yes, it does. So the URL is now what we are currently pointing to. Now, don't worry about this code. Again, the code is going to be in the description to the video below. Then you can just copy and paste it yourself. Right, if we go up to the floppy disk, if you don't know what a floppy disk is, go up to the red thing, click save. Right, now we can close this. Go to configuration. Remember what I said. If you make a change to your configuration, then just check your config. Hopefully it will come back configuration valid. And then we can move on. Yep, configuration valid. So know that it's going to start okay. It's not going to crash on us while it's trying to start. And here you may be able to see that I've just clicked restart. So there is the entry for configurator. We click on that, we will see that we've got all the entries from before when we had it in the previous tab. They come up in our main screen. That is awesome. So now we can just edit our configuration from within Home Assistant itself. And now if we want, we can go back into has.io. We can take a partial snapshot. And we can call it we can just say installed configurator. Right, so it's a partial snapshot. The only ones that we want to check are Home Assistant configuration, because remember we added this in the left-hand side, and the add-on itself, Configurator, and that will save our username and password. Right, so if we create that, we now have a full installation and a partial snapshot from when we installed this. So the next one that we will be installing is, I believe, I will have to check, I believe we're going to install Duck DNS and Let's Encrypt next. And that will basically allow you to access your Home Assistant installation from wherever you are in the world, as long as you have an internet connection. Okay. Right, so if we go back to our config, well, in fact, let's go back to our home screen. And we will leave it there for this episode. So remember, if you've got value from this, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see when the next video comes out, don't forget to click subscribe. All the information that you need is in the notes to the video. All the information. So, cattail number one, cattail number two, cuckoo clock that is 10 minutes off. Right, let's carry on. I have no idea where I was. If you want to know when the next video is coming out in the series, click on subscribe and you will be notified. That is awesome. It would be much appreciated if you know anybody else who you think would get value out of this series, then give them a shout, get them to watch it, get them to like it, give it a thumbs up, give it a subscribe, everything. Okay, right. Thank you very much. It's been an experience. That's because I'm still carrying on from last time. I've not stopped yet. And I'm now going to go on to the next episode. Okay, thanks. Bye-bye.